And that's what that guy ordered for cheese. So if I worked at Subway, I would stock at least a couple merkins just in case a sandwich guy came in. And I would definitely put it on there and then just laugh about thinking about him eating fake pubic hair and be like, this cheese is not the best. I almost got arrested one time for wishing AIDS on a cop. Have you guys heard of AIDS? It's a disease. So I wished it on the cop because he pulled me over for speeding, and I'm fine with that because I was speeding. Then he gave me another ticket for not using my blinker when I pulled over, and that is a crock of shit. Right? All your lights are on, Dick. They know we're going to the shoulder. You need one more blinky light for your parade, princess? Come on, Cinderella. And he said, it's the law. And I said, your law sucks. And he goes, say one more thing. Say one more thing. So I said, I hope you get AIDS. And not like people that are gonna help you with paperwork at the precinct. I'm talking about the AIDS with the capital letters. And he said, get out of the car. And I was like, for what? And he goes, I'm arresting you for wishing AIDS on you? You can't arrest someone for wishing, right? How would you even call that in? We have a 145 hope in progress. I told that story one night and a guy from the back of the room yelled out, I have AIDS. I don't know if you've ever heard a comedy show come to a screeching halt before. But yelling, I have AIDS is definitely a way to make that happen. And I panicked. I was like, did you get your AIDS from being born? No. How about a blood transfusion? No. Well, then it's your fault, right? You can't get mad at me because you got AIDS. I wasn't even there, I don't think. And he goes, what do you mean it's my fault? You had sex and you lost. What do you mean, oh? That's how sexually transmitted diseases work. It's not like he was driving and just fucking had AIDS. He got into something dirty, and that's not on me. Let me give you the Minnesota version of that joke. I don't have an arm. What happened? Auger accident. Was it on? Yep. Well, you're dumb. I mean, there's not... Why are you yelling at me? You stuck your hand in a moving thing. How do you shut off a ceiling fan? Not like that, right? You don't just... Tick, tick, tick. I'm slowing it down. Well, pull the chain, asshole. It's getting all dusty in here. Get a Swifter or something, please. I don't know. The guy got mad at me. I don't know what his story was. He had sex and he lost. Some people feel that way about their children. Right? I mean, I don't. We don't. But some people do. You've seen him out in public, right? Billy, get your little ass up. Settle down. He's a kid. But dumb people, right? They don't know. He has the symptoms. A child has a symptom of an STD. Oh, fuck you, listen. What are you, a scientist? You wanna get up here and give a fucking PowerPoint on this? Because I will tell you, they're like parasites on the human body. Children are. I had to cut a cord to separate my baby from my wife so it would stop stealing shit from my wife's body. Oh, how do you like that? See, that's perfect. I'm smart, you're not. Let's just move on. I can't handle when people go, oh, before they have any fucking clue what's happening. Ew, that was, you know what? I don't know if that's the Lord's way. It isn't. It isn't. We evolved into having cords connect two people and the smaller one stealing shit from the bigger one. And stuff happens to your body, right? You have sex and you get pregnant and stuff happens to your body. You get sick, you get bigger, something falls out of your vagina, and then it eats all your shit for 18 years. That is not a normal occurrence. It seems like a disease. So I could say a dumb person would think that that would be the thing. And this guy got mad at me. He goes, you think kids are annoying? I have to get up every morning and take medication. That's...
How do you think that's worse than... You get to go back to bed when you do that, right? Because when kids wake up, they're just fucking, they're up for the whole day. And my kids have started sleeping in shifts like they're firefighters. One of them's always up in my home, and when one gets tired, they just go wake the other one up. Like they're recharging batteries or something. I'm tired, you gotta go, get up! I got him on the ropes, hustle! He tried to fall asleep, but I just kept tapping him on the forehead. Hey, dad, 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 dad. And you try to sleep through that, you try to fake sleep through that, but they'll open up your eyeball. They open up your eyelid. And they yell into your eyeball, Dad! This is my fucking eye. This is my ear. It's 2 inches apart. How do you not know that this one sees and this one hears? You're gonna have a hard time with the clit, because that is a tricky one to find. If you cannot figure out the eye-ear combination, the human body. Oh, sorry. And my son makes a list for my daughter. Like, he's devious. He goes, listen, here's what you do when you wake up. Drink the rest of his chocolate milk. He'll get super pissed. If you can't drink it all, just spill it and then walk away. But make sure he knows you spilled it, right? Look at him. Look at the milk. Smirk. Look back at him. Stick your foot into the milk and drag your foot out of the kitchen. Number two, if he ever says, hey, don't do that, say you mean this and then do the exact same thing. The closer you can get to his face, the better. And number three, right before you come get me, shake the dog till she pisses on the couch. But don't tell anybody, just flip the cushion over so on the next hot day, the whole house smells like piss. Now go, you gotta go, yeah! I bet AIDS doesn't do that, right? There's no way, that's kids. No, my son's 12. He has this weird attitude, like he thinks he owns Earth, you know? He's getting that guy. Dad, I need a cell phone. For what? Emergencies. Run, bitch. Right? You're 12. Your legs are still under warranty. Well, all my other friends have one. Well, they can call the cops while you go hide in a bush. Shouldn't have to think of everything. You're 12 now. My kids used to ask me a ton of questions, but I have a really good process for that. I laminate some press passes, and 3 times a day in my home I have a press conference. And that is the only time you're allowed to ask me a question. I say, all right, we're having the press conference. They come running in with their press passes, little notebook where they wrote their questions down. All right, we'll go ahead and start. Thank you for coming. Go ahead and go, ladies first, Olivia, first question. Why does your puppy dog stick to the refrigerator? Well, there's a magnet on the back of it. Magnets stick to metal. The refrigerator's made of metal. That's why your puppy dog sticks to the refrigerator. Great question. Isaac, next question. Yeah, sometimes the green jelly beans can be tricky. You stick it in your mouth, you think it's lime, and spearmint sucks. Right? Watch your ass. Smell your jelly beans. Olivia, next question. Because there's a magnet on the back of it. Isaac, next question. Why does your sister cry all the time? Well, that's a great question. I think a lot of people in this house want an answer to that. For starters, as you know, we have wooden floors all over our home, and she runs around in cotton socks like there's not going to be consequences. Not to mention the fact that Crazy never watches where she's going. Do you remember when she hit her face in the side mirror of my car? Oh my God, how did you not see your face coming at you? You never thought, there's my face, but here's my face. I'm gonna slow it down. Awesome question. Olivia, next question. It's a fucking magnet. I come from a broken home, which is not that unusual these days. My parents used to always threaten each other with divorce, and you hear that as a little kid, and you think that's the worst thing one person could ever say to another person. Now I'm married? Not that bad. Like, I love my wife, and it would hurt if she left, but there would be good days. And I'm not even talking about other women. I'm talking about the little things. Like, how about the day I get to go canoeing with somebody else and don't have to do all the paddling? That'd be a great day at my house. I live on a river. My wife said, let's get a canoe. Let's paddle upstream. Let's float back down. I don't think my wife knows what let's means. Because we put the canoe in the water. I started paddling. I looked up and she had not brought a paddle onto the canoe. And I said, hey, what's going on up there? She goes, I'm taking pictures. Well, you could sketch it. We're not moving. It was like I was on a canoe treadmill or something. I could not go. And when you're in the back, you steer. So three big swipes out of me, and we are now on the side of the riverbank. And she turns around and says, what are you doing back there? And I was like, I will kill you. She said, why are you whispering? Because sound travels over water. And that last phrase makes it premeditated. I'm not doing an extra five because you didn't bring a paddle. Then she goes, why don't you sit up front then? Because then I can't see you not paddling. You're not going to trick me with a seating chart. Who thinks it's a good idea to paddle upstream, right? Maybe when we're done, we could throw raspberries at the moon. That is just as logical of a thought. Then my wife had an epiphany. She said, I know. Let's bring the kids next time. Absolutely. Why wouldn't we, right? Kids fix everything. You ever having a bad day? Get some kids in there. See what happens. Huh? Let's mix this up with some sunshine and rainbow, should we? Because kids have a magical ability to bring a situation from damn it to, are you fucking kidding me right now? Sit still. I'm the only one paddling. And I know my kids learn through exploration. I totally get that, you guys. But not when we're on the canoe going upstream. You gotta sit your ass down and be as aerodynamic as possible. My son doesn't get it. He stands up right when we get in the middle of the river and he's like, what's on this side? What's on this side? What's on this side? Well, first of all, the same shit. What do you think changed from here to here? A canoe's a foot and a half across, maybe. But it's too late. The canoe's already rocking. And my daughter's like, we're all gonna die! Maybe. If this keeps up, perhaps. One day my kid said, why'd you take away our life jackets? Because you're not listening. Everybody aboard this vessel knows I will tip a canoe to prove a point. Then my wife said, I needed to wear a life jacket, which is absurd, right? I'm the only one paddling. I'm gonna have a massive tit rash from all the repetitive rubbing. She said, you need to be a good example. Well, I will. If we tip over, I'll swim to shore and still be alive, and our kids could be like, we should learn how to do that. He's halfway to the house. We're still out here bobbing around like a bunch of assholes. One day my kids were crawling all over in the canoe and my wife goes, maybe we need a bigger canoe. I'm like, maybe I need my own apartment. Not to live in, just to reflect in after canoe trips. Right? Maybe put up some posters on the wall or something. I used to have posters. I don't anymore. I have pictures in expensive frames, which is absurd because I was at all that stuff. I don't need those pictures. I was there. Right? I have a memory. We have a family photo in our house. For what? We're all fucking right here. We're all here. I'm looking. I can touch all of you right here. Look at that. I just touched your live version. Why do we need that on the wall? And we're all smiling, which is bullshit at my house.